Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to sort one column containing duplicated values by another column which again contains duplicated values. This doesn't look like a very common scenario, but it's much more frequent than you can imagine, and it's a powerful technique to learn. Let's see that with an example. I have loaded in this model the census of the United States, and I'm slicing by state and by county. What I would like to see are the counties sorted by number of inhabitants, by their population. I can do that with Power BI. I can just click on population and this will sort the entire matrix by population. But I have two issues that I want to solve. The first one, not only the county has been sorted, but also the states. They are no longer in alphabetical sorting. And the second, and probably the worst problem, is that I need to have the population in the matrix in order to be able to sort it. I cannot sort my matrix by a column that does not belong to the matrix itself. So what I would like to do is still use this alphabetical sorting, but have the counties sorted by population. I can use the sort by column feature, but unfortunately this is one of the scenarios where I cannot. Let's browse the data for a bit. You see that I have state, name and population. I created some county here. I have 1077 different counties, but only 800 states, so 800 names, and 1075 different values for the population. So both name and population, they have duplicates. And this is my problem. I cannot sort the name by population. I can give it a try, but if you go to name and ask it to sort it by population, it will raise an error. Now, the error is quite long, but essentially it is saying that there is not a one-to-one relationship between the values in the two columns. What I want to obtain as a result is something different. I don't want to use the name. I want to create a new calculated column, which I call in this example name unique. And if I add it to my report, expanded everything, now you see that I have the states which are sorted alphabetically, whereas the counties are sorted by population. How did I do that? Well, I need to solve two different issues. The first one is that I want to create a new column instead of the population that has unique values and a one-to-one relationship with the name. And then I need also to create a new name so that different counties in different states with the same name appear as different roles, at different values. The reason is they will not have the same sorting in all the states, so they need to be different. Let's solve the problem one by one. First, let's talk about the name. Let's see how the name unique column has been created. Let me just increase the font a bit. Okay, the technique that I'm using for this code has already been explained in another video. And if you're curious about it, go take a look at the video where I give a full explanation of how it works. I basically enumerate all the places which are in the same states, all the counties which are in the same states, and then I rank them one by one, so to assign one number to each different county. And finally, I use the zero width white space to append at the end of each name a different value. At the end, all the names will be different. And this solves the problem for the county. What about the population? Well, population has different values, but I created a sort key column. How do I create the sort key? Well, I need a different value for each value of the population, but in case I have two different counties with the same population, I want to assign them two different sort keys. There are a lot of ways of building it. What I did is I first computed the number of rows in the table, and I need it because I have two columns in my sorting. One is the population, the other one is the census key. It's just a number that enumerates all the different counties. The population is much more relevant than the key. So in my sort order, I will multiply the population by the number of rows so to obtain a huge number that will guarantee that the census key will be only a secondary sorting. So I first retrieve all the key and population, and then I rank over this table the expression census population times times number of rows plus the key. The result is a number that grows from 1 to the number of keys in a monotonically way. Once I have it, now I can go to Name Unique and use Sort by Column and sort it by the key. Once this is done, I have my report and I can choose, instead of the name, the unique name that will create the correct sorting. Now, sorting doesn't look like a very important topic to cover. Indeed it is, because if you provide the correct sorting to your data, then your users will see first the most relevant information, and browsing the data will be much, much better. If you like these kind of topics, please come to sqlbi.com, where you will find a full article explaining the technique that I described here, and you also have the option of downloading the PBIX file so you can play with it and learn more. Have fun with DAX!